Hello from Utrecht at Maliban as we get ready for the first international spring break.
The story of how SpringAGE came about, and when I, you know, just listening to everybody's feelings, it's exactly that. South Africa is a contrast. It's this beautiful, green, bright, fresh, hopeful, but at the bottom of it you see employment issues, and like SpringAGE sounds so fresh and so beautiful, but we're dealing with a really serious topic. About, I'm not sure when I read this stat, but a couple of months ago I read a statistic from a book called Why Africa is Poor, but it like really alarmed me, and it said in 2030, which is not really far from now, one quarter of the young people in all the world will come from sub-Saharan Africa. So 25% of the youth of the world will come from my part of the world. Nelly, in fact, was at a conference, and one of our very big businesswomen, Maria Ramos, she was speaking, and she was talking about how South Africa in 2025, which is even closer, is going to have one of the youngest working populations in the world. And that's simply because places like Europe and Asia have just got an older generation. They're no longer making children, they're getting older and older to work, whereas South Africa and the rest of Africa and the likes of India have our pyramid has changed. We're getting younger and younger and younger. So we're getting more young people needing jobs and going into the job industry. That scared me because South Africa is, because we're young and we're dealing with so many things, has got issues on so many levels. We've got a skills shortage in our country. So in all the world, we can't really compete on skill. The likes of India, for instance, is kicking our ass when it comes to engineers and accountants. And they've just got a lot of them. South Africa, unfortunately, because of, apartheid and the lack of education for so long, our skill base, we really can't compete. Our workforce is quite expensive in South Africa. We can't compete with China. We can't work as cheaply, as fastly, and as skilled as the Chinese people. And the few jobs that we do have, clever people in Europe are making machines to automate them. So I'm going, we have a lot of young people with no jobs. A lot of young people that we can't employ. So it was exactly that. We're going, okay, we have to do something about it. We've got 15 years, new country, new democracy. Nelly and I started grade one, or our first start of school, in 1993. And we finished. We're the first generation in our country that has had a democratic education. There's only been one generation that has had a good education in our country. So that's a little bit compared to the rest of the world, but it's enough to do something about it. There's enough of us, clever, talented, motivated, globally competitive young people to come together and start becoming the solution of our country. And that's really from our heart where SpringAGE started. And like Steph was saying, we're growing. I came here in March and we didn't have anything. We didn't know how to go about it. And it's really been a beautiful year of working with Nelly and us just saying, how do we make this come alive? How do we start to engage young people to bring this alive and start having tangible solutions? So we thank you for being part of us, and us being in this room is really part of growing SpringAGE, how we do what we do, and also learning from other people around the world.
Our country's got a question, and the question that our country's asking is, how do we decrease unemployment?
But in your world, what are themes that are interesting to you? Mm-hmm. You might not even know if there's a solution in there. Tonight is not really about looking for solutions. If we do, we do. But how a topic that intrigues you, that interests you, that we can engage in, and perhaps come up with creative ideas. So it's, yeah, don't stay too far out of your world. What interests you and what's your theme?
And I think what's also important, which I forgot to mention, is that once we come up with the three themes, and so whoever's interested in any other another theme, we'll go join the theme that somebody else has come up with. So what's going to happen is that we can just go into a group that we feel that might interest us, and then we'll all just engage in the topic. And we've got a free space where if we'd like to go to more than one topic, we have the ability to do so as well.
We about to step into the light.
Maybe getting an understanding of where we are.
Yo. We about to step.